Thank you, Dr. Adriana Sanford, and good morning. I want to take the time to welcome the 2020 cohort there at OU. It's certainly an honor and a pleasure to be in your virtual presence. My understanding is that you're about to embark on an executive MBA program there at OU. And it's great that you've made the leap from finishing your undergraduate studies and embarking upon your graduate studies. I'll share a little story with you that perhaps will help you and even put you at ease. When I was studying engineering at the undergraduate level, I always wondered, what does an engineer do? And as a freshman, I didn't worry about it. Then I became a sophomore, I became a junior, and I still didn't know what an engineer did. And that was my major. I reached my senior year, and I was walking the line graduating in my undergraduate engineering degree, and I still didn't know what an engineer did. And then I went to work, and then I went to graduate school, and then came back to work. And I found out something that was very important that I think I can relate it to you guys, again, to put you at ease, is that when you walk in the door of a university as a freshman, undergraduate, you walk in with a toolbox that's empty. And when you walk out and you graduate with your four-year degree, you've got tools in that toolbox. And you go to work, and now you can rely on those tools to solve those problems. Sometimes you use the least efficient tool, but you still get the job done and you learn. And with that experience, you learn to use the right tools. Then when I went to graduate school, I came back and now I had another toolbox. It had power tools. And because of that additional training, you were able to solve more complex problems, take on more complex projects, and we're able to get the job done. So I admire folks that decide to embark upon their graduate degrees, and especially you folks that are going for your executive MBA degree there at OU University. And so aside from that, I also wanna talk about navigating your career, because undoubtedly in 2 years or so, you'll finish your executive MBA program and you'll go out to industry and start working if some of you aren't working now as it is. And one of the things that's important is you have to keep your eye on the prize. What is your long-term objective in your career? And you have to start mapping that out as soon as you start your first job, because I'll share with you how I became an astronaut. And that was, you know, I started working at a national research laboratory, which is Lawrence Livermore National Lab. And the very first project I accepted was in the X-ray laser program, developing a nuclear pumped X-ray laser that was going to be deployed up in space as a defense shield. The fact that it was a weapon, I didn't care much for, but the fact that we can take hardware and put it up in space, that's what interested me. Because that's it. If I get experience in that, NASA's going to be interested in me. So I did that work. Once that project was completed, I worked in the digital mammography arena, where we basically applied a lot of that technology in the X-ray laser program and helped develop the first full-field digital mammography system for the earlier detection of breast cancer, a technology that undoubtedly has saved thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of lives since we invented that digital mammography system. Again, I accepted that job because I figured anything medical related, NASA would be interested in. Finally, I then accepted a job in the nuclear non-proliferation arena, where that took me to Russia over the course of 5 years, 25 trips to Siberia of all places, to help inspect and make sure that the Russians were abiding by agreed to agreements with the U.S. in terms of downsizing their nuclear arsenal. I didn't take that job because I wanted to get to know Siberia in the middle of winter. I took that job because I had read in the newspaper that Russia and the U.S. had signed an agreement to build what was going to be the International Space Station. It doesn't take a rocket scientist to figure out, even though I am one, that that we were going to be working with the Russians in space in the near future. So when I saw this job open up, man, I jumped on it like a fly on flypaper. And not only that, I also told my boss if he would be willing to pay for one-on-one Russian language instructions. And of course, they had a continuing education program. They said, yes, knock yourself out. And 5 years later, я понимаю по-русски язык, I learned Russian. So after I did that, guess what? NASA was interested in me as a candidate for being an astronaut. This was after 11 rejections. So it wasn't until the 12th try that I got selected. So that's another characteristic that I want to instill upon you is make sure you have perseverance. If you really want that goal, keep your eye on the prize, map it out, and never give up. So once again, I want to congratulate the 2020 cohort for the executive MBA program there at OU. Have a lot of fun in the process, learned a lot, and I'm sure all of you will reach your own stars. Thank you.